Have you heard of superintelligence? It's a thing. Let's talk about it. So welcome back to AI Insights and Innovation, the one place where we'll tell you how to make AI work for your enterprise. I'm your host, David Linthicum, AI expert and analyst. Let's get going. So OpenAI announced, has been announcing, and everybody covered it, that they're working on and have created some improvements in AI to, and then something they call superintelligence. So what is that? So superintelligence refers to an artificial intelligence system that surpasses human intelligence in, you know, practically all fields, including creativity, general wisdom, social skills. And we've been making this prediction, by the way, since artificial intelligence first came around. I was working on it when I was 19 years old, believe it or not, as a Lisp programmer. And we were always waiting for the world where it was going to become self-aware and it was going to basically live up to the promises that we saw in science fiction movies. So far, not hit that yet. So at the end of the day, you know, AI is an amazing tool, but it's just as smart as the data that we train it on. And its ability to create net new ideas seems to be something it's lacking. Everybody who uses AI, I think after they kind of get comfortable with it, they kind of realize that, you know, it does have some limitations. And we as humans can create net new ideas, you have a eureka moment, so to speak, where AI is typically not going to be able to do that. Well, superintelligence is going to change that. So this represents a future where AI's decision-making ability and problem-solving skills will exceed our own. And so they'll become more intelligent than humans, therefore more useful than humans. Obviously, there's a lot of issues that come that arise in thinking about that. And let's talk around what they are. So OpenAI has some visions and warnings about superintelligence. Their CEO, Sam Altman, asserts that superintelligence era has begun and urges the world to prepare. He highlights both the incredible promise and significant risks associated with the rapid advancing AI. Now, there's a couple things at work here. Number one, OpenAI is truly an innovative company. They didn't create generative AI, but I think they certainly made it popular in releasing ChatGPT and the usage of that. And now we have hundreds and hundreds of LLMs that are out there. They're very useful tools to leverage either as a way to automate our business or a way to automate our lives or even changing the way in which we deal with computers in our personal lives. However, what's happened now is we're seeing kind of a stagnation in the innovation that's occurring in the AI space. And quite frankly, because everything in terms of the impressive work that was occurring around AI has been on the development of the LLMs. LLMs are trained on the entire data in the universe at the end of the day to become as useful as they are. And we're kind of running out of data to train on. In other words, we're generating new data each and every day. But as far as training a new model that's going to have some impressive capabilities, we don't have 50, 60 years of past data as past binary data to go through to train ourselves. So we're incrementally improving data, and therefore the models are incrementally improving, and we're not seeing the innovation gains that we saw just a few years ago when the generative AI revolution, hit. And so now they're pointing to the next generation of it. So in other words, they're trying to get above the noise, and they're talking about something new and creative and exciting, and certainly superintelligence is going to be that. But just kind of keep in mind what's going on here. There's a bit of architecture here, a bit of promises that are made in terms of technology arriving that's going to revolutionize the world. Wait and see, wait and see, wait and see. Pay attention to us, pay attention to us, pay attention to us. And you kind of have to take that with a grain of salt if you understand the market motivations behind it. So there's some opportunities here. If OpenAI and other companies are able to pull this off, superintelligence could help solve critical global challenges, medical breakthroughs, the climate change solutions. However, it also poses risks of misuse, loss of control, societal disruption, if it's not poorly managed. And if they do pull this off, I do think we're going to see some regulations around it, just because it, if it is as good as that, it's able to replace a human in every way, then we kind of have to ask ourselves, are we part of the use case into the future? And there has to be some ethical controls and legal controls around that, I'm thinking. I'm not into, pushing regulatory, action in this kind of stuff, certainly around technology like AI. We tried that before. It doesn't work very well. However, we kind of have to consider what the impact's going to be. So in other words, it's not asking the question, can we? It's asking the question, should we? And in many instances, we're going to find that we can, but perhaps we should not. And so this may be one of those things if, again, they pull this off. However, it's incredibly hard to build a system that's going to have true creative thinking like we do as humans. We kind of take for granted the fact that we come up with ideas and we're able to look at information and understand the information, and that's our learning, our ability to repeat things we already have understood. But as far as putting it together in kind of a net new idea that's going to be truly creative, that is a tough process to replicate in AI. We've been trying to do it for many, many years. Everybody thinks they're close to it. I just don't think they're going to replicate it as easy as they think. And if we do see it, I think it's going to be more creativity simulation, where they're able to simulate creativity, but it's not true creativity unto itself. And so when you talk about superintelligence, okay, a very hypey word, are they going to get to creating something that's far more intelligent than a human? I doubt that's going to be something we're going to see very soon. I'm a technology geek. I like technology evolution and just understanding all the moving components that need to happen to pull that off. That may not be something that we see as soon as Sam Altman says we're going to see it. So obviously people go right to, you know, safety and governance of this kind of technology. So Altman stresses the urgent need for global regulation, oversight, and collaboration, safety efforts. And this is going to ensure ethical development and deployment of this technology, preventing the concentration of power, ultimately should be at the top of priority. So he's concerned about governments, industries, companies, you know, that can afford this technology. It's going to be pretty expensive, I'm sure, and that are able to weaponize it fairly quickly and get a substantial gain on the competition, or in the case of governance, this is government's substantial gain on other countries. And so it gets political real quick. And so I'm not sure if we should be hitting the alarm bell on that yet. I think we've always been thinking about the ethical, you know, consequences of AI, and we're going through that now. Obviously, AI is going to have the ability to replace a lot of people out there who are humans, you know, truck drivers with self-driving cars, logistics systems that are able to eliminate the number of humans that are there. You're able to, you know, run ports, you know, entirely using robotics and AI. All that stuff is technology we can use today. And we just have to consider the consequences of doing that. And as a technologist, I'm go for using technology to create a true force multiplier for the enterprises and companies that use them. But we do have to think about impact. We do have to think about the ethical concerns. And I think that he's saying that. I think that's fine. But as far as, are we going to have to consider this in the next couple of years? Probably not. I just think it's a little bit further off than that. So you'll find that they talk less about what the technology is going to be capable of and really kind of the regulatory and ethical issues around it. And I think that's common with AI systems. I rather see the technology show up before we start talking about the ethical and regulatory needs of regulating the technology. I think we're trying to discuss something that only exists conceptually now. And so if it exists in reality and they're able to pull it off, then we can start discussing the societal impact and ethics impacts, things like that. So the development and regulation of superintelligence is going to require international collaboration and broad public engagement. And so OpenAI is, you know, obviously kind of virtual signaling a little bit. They're going to encourage the transparent discussion and shared responsibility to maximize the benefits and reduce risks, yada, yada, yada. That's always going to be the case. The issue is going to be that we're not very good at doing cross-country and geopolitics regulation. So we're going to be able to regulate and control a particular country, United States, you know, UK, things like that. But as far as controlling the world and their ability to use this technology, that's something that's just not going to happen. We just don't have we've tried this in the past, international regulations, international law, unless it's enforced by each individual country the same way, isn't going to be effective. So count on this technology, if it does happen, when it gets out into the market, There's going to be pretty much no regulations on in terms of how it's going to be used, just because every country is going to have to agree upon, you know, some sort of an ethical use case, some sort of regulations around the use of this technology, set the limits, define the details behind it. I don't see that happening. So as far as this technology will take us, I think that's as far as everybody's going to use it. We saw that with generative AI. And obviously, you know, people were talking about regulating it and its ability to, you know, stay out of schools, and, you know, students are using it to write term papers and things like that. We just can't unring those bells. If we release the technology into the marketplace, consider everybody is going to have an opportunity to use it at the greatest extent of the technological capabilities as to their ability to bring value unto themselves personally. And so companies are going to use it for their own selfish gains, and that's what companies do. People are going to use it for their own selfish gains, and that's what people do. So this idea that we're going to have some sort of a twinge of ethics when this game-changing technology hits the streets probably is being a little naive right now. I just don't think we're going to have the ability to put the genie back in the bottle if we do release the genie. So we need to understand that that's a likely outcome. So once it's out there, it's going to be very difficult to control, no matter if you're government, no matter if you're company, no matter if you're a person. So that's all I have for this week. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and check out our other assets here on theCUBE. Also, reach out to me if you have any questions. So until next week, you guys stay real safe. Cheers.